there! I'm Daria and today I'm going to tell you how to assemble a video tutorial all by yourself. Let's go! In the last episode, we were explaining how to make a screencast, a video captured from the computer screen for a video tutorial. You can find the link to that video in the description. With the help of a video captured from your computer screen, you can visually show your friends, work colleagues, or subscribers how to use a particular program. But if you want to create a fully-fledged video tutorial or a program review, you're going to need montage. So, today I'm going to tell you how to use montage to create a complete video tutorial based on a simple screen recording from your computer.
In the earlier episode, we recorded a screencast using Screen Capture Studio. In the program window that appears right after you've finished the screen recording, click Open in Editor. Screen Capture Studio is a good tool for this, because the program does both. It captures the desktop, and it includes a standalone editor, where you get to build your montage. As you can see, the screencast we recorded is on the timeline in the video editor. If you recorded your screencast in parts, upload the remaining files with the other recordings of your screen. To do that, click Add Media Files in the File tab. Let's just tweak our recording of the computer screen a bit. Shall we? Remember how we did everything slowly and didn't rush? Now we can cut out the parts where we have nothing going on the screen. But we need to make it so that the mouse cursor isn't jerking around. Since that would make it look like you cut out a large part and recorded it a few times. Now, it should look as if you did it all flawlessly and at the same speed. A video tutorial with no sound or comments from the presenter is a bit boring. Showing and explaining at the same time – that's what a good teacher does. If you didn't add any comments while you were recording, you can upload an audio file with a voiceover that you've recorded in advance. Or you can switch on the microphone and record your comments on the spot while editing. It might even be easier. At Movavi, we record screencasts for our tutorials first and then record a voiceover afterwards.
Here is a quick tip. Try editing the presenter's commentary so that the voiceover is a little ahead of the video actions. Show, then tell, but make sure the commentary doesn't lag behind. In the description, you'll find a link to our earlier episode on how to record a voiceover.
In the most recent episode, we advise that you record a stand-up. That is, record shots with the presenter of your video tutorial for the introduction and conclusion. Upload video files to the program and add in some screencasts for variety. Drag the edge of the clip or use split to cut off unwanted extra footage from the stand-up or screencasts. You've probably noticed that Movavi video tutorials start with a greeting from the presenter. We also include stand-ups in the middle of the video to create natural breaks in the tutorial. And at the end, to say bye to viewers and include the subscription button. You can do the same or come up with your own way of framing your tutorial. You could leave your stand-up and screencast without any transitions. It would look like this. Another option would be to use the transitions from the program's built-in collection. Like this one. There are over 100 transitions to choose from in Movavi Screen Capture Studio. You can also use other transitions with a green background. You'll find a free pack of these transitions on our channel. As usual, the link is in the description. So our video tutorial is almost done. But let's not rush to save it and upload it on YouTube quite yet. There is one more way to make your video tutorial even more clear and helpful. Open the Callouts tab. Here you'll find arrows, connector lines, signs, and other graphic elements that you can use to highlight an important part of your tutorial. Let's take this arrow as an example. We just drag it into the preview window, adjust the size, position and turn, and click Apply. Now the arrow is pointing at the button we need to push. You can specify the exact time when it should appear and fade away on the timeline. Trust me, with an obvious prompt like a big arrow above a button, your friends, colleagues and subscribers will get what needs to be done much more quickly. Aside from shapes and arrows, Screen Capture Studio also lets you add titles, subtitles and speech bubbles. These come in handy for important comments that might be hard to follow as you listen. Besides, animated subtitles look great at the beginning if you want to title your tutorial or name the different parts. One more tip. To make the text in your video readable, use colored rectangles from the Callouts collection as a background for the words. Just remember to place the clip with the chosen shape below the text on the timeline.
Now I'm confident you'll be able to make your own video tutorials that'll be at least as good, if not better, than the ones we make on the Movavi channel. If you missed the first part of the tutorial, go here! That's where I tell you how to record a screencast. Whoa, it just hit me! What if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet? Is that even possible? Well, just in case, I'm leaving the subscription button right here. Bye-bye!